It's really hard to be after Christoph. I'll be careful next year. So I'm really happy to be here today. First of all, I don't know if everyone knows me. I'm Ines Teacă. I'm a data analytics professional. I'm here today as a representative of Our Lady's Bucharest. And let's say my presentation is aiming to promote R locally. This is my aim. And of course, I'm also here as a co-organizer of MeasureCamp, which aims to promote the data analytics and CRAW function locally. As Our Lady's promoter, I also promote gender minorities. So this is why I'm here. I'm a woman. And this is why we had Christa. So I would say we are here also in promoting women and men together in creating, let's say, a safe and a full picture structure. Good. I will give you some highlights about me. I'm a technology and data enthusiast. I have a background really crossed. I would say that I started as a customer care in a telco. I invested my time usually in roles regarding data. I had some experience also in direct marketing industry. I worked for Reader's Digest. So I would say direct marketing is one of my love story. And I'm also involved in ONGs. I volunteer as today for MeasureCamp, but also for Coder Dojo, which is promoting programming for kids, and Our Lady's promoting gender minorities. Just to have a background about me. I will set some expectation. I usually do that. I have prepared such a presentation for MarTech, where I started to, let's say, feel comfortable speaking about R. So I think it's very important to know that this is a presentation which promotes options. So don't take it as you should do it like that. You have these options, use them, and well, enjoy. We usually, in a digital area, we are somehow really busy in trying to help everyone. As my previous presenter were stating, we have a lot of data because customers are somewhere around here. I should use this. So customer is here. He actually wants a pair of shoes, but while trying all this pair of shoes, he finds out that he has a new offer. So he goes from offline to online. And for us, in the digital data teams, even if we are data science, data miner, and whatever other names you want, for us it's like that. Let's make sense of this data. So this is a challenge we are facing all the time. And what I discovered last year, because I am an R user for several years, but I haven't used R because in my experience I used corporate solutions, so I never needed to think out of the box. Last year I had to do that, so I discovered R. And what I can do with R. So what I'm going to talk about will be some options. A first option which helps us a lot in the digital, it's the Google Sheets library. We usually hear a lot about reports in Google Sheets. We want to see A/B testing, we want to export all kind of results, or we just want to build in the Google Sheets because we can share it faster and so on. Well, for us as data analysts, we are able, using this package, Google Sheets, which will be, let's say, updated next year with Google Sheets for being more, let's say, accustomed to the technology. We can write, read those kinds of files, and as Christian probably told you in the morning, we can use these options to create somehow a part of the omnichannel funnel. This is one option. Another library which I use, and I know locally we are using a lot of PHP, which usually works with MariaDB or MySQL. We have this option of R MySQL. We can easily connect to such data structure. We can easily create queries. So we can run the queries on the SQL database, but we can also bring the data and curate it in our RStudio framework, which is, let's say, a good workaround when you have, for example, some information which is brought in the MySQL, and out of there you want to take some conclusion, some insights on specific results. I don't know, maybe you have some assisted leads and you want to know how you were performing the previous day or even during the day. This is an option for connection. Another package in R which is well known is the Tidyverse ecosystem. It's actually, let's say, a complete package, because when you install Tidyverse, you actually make use of more libraries which are specialized based on their focus on the full picture of data flow. So you have the import phase, so you have the import part, you have then the part in which you are preparing the data, yeah, you have the part in which you, let's say, transform a bit your data using LubriDate for dates or DeepLear for structuring the data. You could easily compare DeepLear with SQL, so this is an easy way to handle your data. And then you have PUR and, of course, ggplot, which helps you to visualize your graphics. Okay, in terms of visualization, I recommend, or at least I used ggplot. It has very good customization. You can easily create all sorts of graphs. I just selected just to show you. And if you want to bring some dynamism into your visualization, you can use Plotly. Plotly, besides the way ggplot visualizes the data, it actually brings some dynamism in the sense that you are going to see the labels here, and you will be also able to zoom in or zoom out. So it has very good feature in this sense. Okay. Now, strictly related to digital analytics, this is the library I use. This is the Google Analytics R. It's quite easy. It's developed by a team of digital analysts. One is Mark Edmondson, which I highly recommend to follow, or dartistic.com, which is a blog specialized on the digital side. With this tool, with this library, it's very useful to understand a bit the data from Google Analytics. So for me, you have to understand I'm coming from a background of pure analytics, which is SaaS mainly, so I'm used to see the data. While in Google Analytics, you usually see some reports with clicks, and you don't see what's in it behind. So what it really helped me using this library was actually to understand the structure behind Google Analytics, to understand the metadata, to understand the custom dimension, to understand exactly how the views are working from Google, And this is the library which I very easily query from RStudio. I import my data. This is the manual, simple way of doing it. And then I can even analyze or visualize this information. Besides that, if you are, for example, focused on SEO or PPC, sorry.
You know, we had this discussion about using the, I was using for data from Adobe Analytics with Python, very similar to what you're doing, and I was just wondering, is there, in what use cases do you actually need to pull the underlying data? What was it that you were trying to achieve that you could not do?
So for example, now we have also Data Studio, but there are some use cases in which you want to debug the process. So for me, as I told you, I'm not a click. Data Studio usually, or at the beginning, now it evolved. It was very clickable type tool. So I wanted to see the structure of the data. That was the first. The use case here was actually to understand if the data is correctly in the work, in the views. So I wasn't aware, you know, because in Google Analytics you have sample reports. You can actually, let's say, cancel the sampling, but however, there are some differences. So in my use case, it was actually to understand if I have the correct variables, and then to be sure that the data that is kept in the data layer in all this context is accurate. So for this, I have to extract this. Yeah, another use case would be actually to see if you are tracking correctly your campaigns, your UTM codes and mediums, and the UTM campaigns. It's easier to extract from here. I create the pivot. That would be one option. And another option would be to connect it with Shiny. And then you go into a real-time context because, I'll get there because I'm going to show you a bit later. The Search Console, it's useful if you have a framework which is in cloud. And let's say you bring the data and you create some scores. So for this use case, you could use Search Console, for example. I don't want to go too much in detail because, as you know, as last time, we can discuss afterwards. But there are some particular use case. BigQuery as well, there is this library in which you can connect BigQuery as well, because you could create your container inside the cloud, you could bring there all your data, you can apply your algorithm, so it's fully, let's say, flexible on your requirements. Yeah, I will just give you something which is funny, because we are, I think I'm almost at the end. So, questions afterwards. This is a very cool library which I recommend. So, for example, if you want to see who is going to win next week, you could use Google Trends. It's very simple. I didn't put here the script, but I'll come back if you want. You can check the trends from Google Trends. You know the tool Google Trends? Yeah? Okay. So, using this library, you can easily create a query. You can add there the information you want to query from the service. You have a limitation, I think, of five names, structures, whatever, components, five components. And then you can query specifically for Romanian language, for different, so exactly like in Google Trends, but just doing it by a query. You can then create using ggplot, which I was telling you about earlier, this nice graph, and you can have a feel of what the people are thinking, or at least what they are searching. Yeah. And next, I would say this is the most advanced option from R. It's the Shiny library. I think this is newest, a newest option, because what Shiny does, it helps you structure a dashboard without the need of buying Tableau or ClickView. It can connect to various sources of data. This is a dashboard I didn't do. It's a dashboard which is there marked. I think it's built by Mark Edmondson, but I'll tell you afterwards because I can't remember. What it's really cool is that it's a real-time dashboard, so it can connect to Google Analytics directly. You can see what are the trends and how your KPIs are going on that time. And besides that, for example, in this dashboard, you have the Prophet library, which is a library developed by Facebook for Arima methodology, which predicts in advance. So you can also see how it's going to evolve your traffic. I would say it's quite a good option if you don't want to spend money or too much money. You could do it in R. And yeah, the end. So if you have any questions, feel free. As I told you, it's just a way of thinking that there is another life beside the BigQuery, Python, or whatever other tools we have. We also have the options.
Yeah, question.
Yeah, please.
Have you ever tried to use Google R for analyzing the campaigns? Do you have best practices? Could you kind of give an example how we did it?
What do you mean best practices?
I'm just starting with R, so yeah. I'm not really into it yet, but I would love to analyze in campaigns which brought the most money, not just like looking at a table, but really have analyzed data through R. So,
first of all, are you from Bucharest?
Sorry?
Are you from Bucharest?
No.
Okay, so what you could start, first you have to install R in your studio. That would be your first step. Secondly, you should connect, you are talking about campaigns, digital campaigns, right?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah. Afterwards, you can install your library, Google Analytics app. Exactly this script. And after you are set, you have to export your campaign codes and the duration which is needed for you, and afterwards you have to start to compute. Be sure that you have tracked correctly your conversion goals, so you can extract them as well. For example, here you have the data range, and for conversion goals, because you would probably want to see if you have a conversion completed, you have to fill them here. Here there is a limitation, please don't use it because you probably want to see all the interval. And then you have to use DeepLib and to start to complete your KPIs.
Thank you.
Or you can come also to our ladies Bucharest and I can help you more.
Thank you.
Yeah. It always depends on the campaign side what objectives you have. So if you have a objective of just being there, then I would strongly suggest you to focus more on the side that it's tracked. It's correctly tracked as expected, on the interval you want, and so forth. If you are focused on a specific target, like sales, be sure that you have that funnel well defined, and see if it's as expected. I mean, it depends on your PNL.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So I guess we are.